You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate.
Hello everybody, this is Overboy, and I'm going to be doing my review for the 1974 movie, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The movie is directed by Toby Hooper and written by Kim Hinkle and Toby Hooper, and follows a group of friends who are after going to a cemetery to make sure that their grandfather's grave wasn't robbed, because there had been grave robbers reported on the news and stuff. They were on their way back but ran out of gas, so they were planning on hanging out at their grandpa's old house. And everything, and they kind of decide to go exploring on this trail and everything. It leads to the house of the Sawyer family, and that's when things kind of start getting crazy. So this is a really good movie. It's one of the best horror movies of all time and everything. I definitely could say that. And the cast in this is really good. Marilyn Burns plays Sally, who is the final girl, and I think she does a pretty good job. I know I've heard some people say that she was kind of annoying and stuff, the way she screams, and I can kind of see that. Her screaming, it was a little bit over the top and everything, but at the same time, I also can understand why she was screaming and everything. But I thought she was a pretty good final girl. Paul A. Partain plays Franklin, who is Sally's brother. I know a lot of people don't like Franklin, and they say he's just really annoying and everything, but I don't think he's as bad as everybody says. I mean, he is kind of whiny and stuff, but at the same time, he's also kind of humorous and stuff, like when he says, if I have too much of more of a good time, I don't know if I can take it, or something like that. It just cracks me up the way he talks and everything. He's just he does a really good job as Franklin. Alan Danziger, I probably butchered that last name, plays Jerry, who is, I believe he's Sally's love interest. I think he was pretty good. He doesn't have a whole lot to do. Most of these characters outside of Franklin and Sally don't really have that much to do in this movie, except for kind of pretty much just get killed. And then William Vale plays Kirk, who is the first victim of Leatherface. He gets a sledgehammer to the head, which was a pretty cool scene. It's when we very first really get to see Leatherface. I thought he was pretty cool. That was pretty cool. Terry McMahon is the one that is dating Kirk, and of course she gets killed by Leatherface. He takes her and puts her on the meat hook thing in the basement, but it has one of the most iconic scenes when she's trying to run out of the house, and he goes up and grabs her from behind and carries her back in the house. It's just a really iconic and awesome scene and everything. And then Edwin Neal plays the hitchhiker who they meet at the beginning of the movie, who's one of the Sawyer family members. I think his name is Nubbins, I think is what his real name is, but in the credits he's just called the hitchhiker. But he is really awesome. I love the whole crazy psycho-ness of him, and I think Edwin Neal does a really great job playing him. I love, like, when they're in the van and stuff, he's cutting his hand and everything, and he really gets Franklin paranoid throughout the rest of the movie because he's afraid that the guy's trying to look for him and everything. I thought that he was really good. He's really crazy and stuff. And then Jim Cito plays Drayton Sawyer, who in this movie is just credited as the old man. I thought he was really good too. He's one of my favorite characters in the franchise. I love him in this movie. And Gunnar Hansen was great as Leatherface. He's one of my favorite versions of the character. I thought he was great. I love the scene when he's, when we first see him chasing Sally after he kills Franklin. He feels really intimidating and stuff in that scene. And at the end of it, when he's doing that weird dance that he does at the, during the very last scenes of the movie, I don't know why. I know it's an iconic scene and everything, but I don't know why. I always thought that scene was really cool for some reason. Maybe it's just because of how iconic it is. And then John Dugan plays Grandpa Sawyer, who is pretty much like in this wheelchair, and he looks so old and stuff, you can't tell if he's actually alive or not and everything. I thought that he did a good job too. I thought that the makeup effects they used on him was really good. All the makeup effects and costumes and everything they used for this movie was really good and everything. And I think the cinematography is some of the best in a horror movie. It just has a really good feel to it. It feels like it's realistic and like the and everything. Something I love about this movie is how real it feels.
Yeah.
It has that dirtiness to it that makes you feel dirty when you're watching it. If that makes any sense. I know, like, the very first time I watched this, I felt like I needed to take a shower after I watched it, because it just feels so gritty and stuff. The score was done by Toby Hooper and Wayne Bell, and I thought their score was done very, very good and everything. Yeah, and I think it fit this movie really well. And I really enjoyed this movie. You could tell that it was a low budget movie and everything. I think it was only made for like $8,000 or something like that. Sorry about that. But it just is a really, really entertaining movie. There's everything. It's not as rewatchable as some of the other movies, other horror movies, famous horror movies, but I still think it was entertaining and stuff, and I think it was definitely a lot better than I remembered it, because I remember liking it a lot when I watched it the first time, but I enjoyed it even more this time, and it's been a few years since the last time I saw it and everything. So, but this is definitely one that if you haven't seen, I would definitely recommend it, because it's one I think that every horror movie fan should definitely see at least once and everything. It doesn't have a lot of gore in it, but that doesn't really bother me too bad. I mean, the first Halloween didn't either and everything, and it does have a lot more blood in it than the first Halloween did and everything. I know that Toby Hooper also said that when they were making this movie, he was going for a dark comedy, and while I do kind of see some of the humorous parts in it, I don't fully see how it's really supposed to be a comedy, because it's pretty creepy and everything. But he has a really dark, twisted sense of humor, which I do too, but I kind of saw a little bit of the humor, like with Franklin and like the scene when they're all howling and stuff when she's crying. I kind of thought that was a little bit more humorous this time when I rewatched it and everything, knowing that that was probably one of those scenes that he intended on being more funny than scary and everything. But like I said, this is a really great movie and everything. So I'd give the Texas Chainsaw Massacre 1974 a 10 out of 10, and definitely recommend it if you haven't seen it and everything, especially if you're a horror fan. This is one of those that I feel like is a must see and everything. But I hope you enjoyed this review, and I'll be reviewing Texas Chainsaw Massacre 2 or sometime within the next day or two, probably later tonight or tomorrow. depending on when I get done watching it. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and have a good day, everybody.
Mock! Yeah! Ing! Yeah! Bird! Yeah! 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 Mockingbird! Don't everybody have you heard?
Have you heard?
She's gonna buy me a mockingbird! And if that mockingbird don't sing, she's gonna buy me a diamond ring!
And if that diamond ring don't